Let us move further to the capsule filling methods now. So what are the methods and what are the machines that are used for capsule filling? Let us talk about the machines first. Okay. The different machines that are used for capsule filling are classified as small scale, medium scale, or large scale. They can be also known as hand operated capsule filling machine, semi-automatic capsule filling machine, and automatic capsule filling machine. What they differ is, they differ in the procedure also, they differ in the labor that has been required into it, and they mainly differ into the production capacity. Okay. The production capacity of hand operator is going to be less, more would be semi-automatic, and highest would be the automatic. Hence, it is used for large scale, medium scale, and small scale manufacturing. Okay, we are going to see this machine today in detail. Okay, in our tutorial that we have started with today. Okay, where we are going to see the different machines and its videos. Okay, and there are some steps involved. Okay, in the capsule filling machine, the steps are rectification, separation of caps, and empty capsules. So all these. Okay, if you take any of this machine, all these steps are involved in any of this machine. So these are the general steps. That a general method in order to fill. Now what we are doing is, we have earlier manufactured the capsule gelatin, then we have prepared the capsule shell from it. That procedure we have seen. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to fill this capsule shell with what? With the drug and the other excipient inside it. So for doing that, there are some specific steps that are involved. The first step is known as rectification. In rectification, what happens is, the cap and the body, they are aligned, they are oriented such that cap is on the top and body is below it, and you have the body below it. Okay, so this alignment of cap and body, okay, where cap is on the top and body below, this alignment, this orientation is known as rectification. In the second step, what happens is, this cap and body, they are separated. You remove this cap and this body is been separated. In the third step, what you do is, these bodies are now filled with the powder material. Powder means your drug as well as your excipient, with your formulation. You fill this body with your excipient and drug. That is the formulation. So this is the next step, that is filling of body. Next is removal of the excess of material. So whatever is the excess material, that has been removed from it. In the next step, what you do is, this cap is again placed onto this body. So replacing of this cap is the next step. The next step would be sealing, whereby this body and cap, they would be joined to each other to make it tamper proof. And the last step would be, this is getting now polished. So these are the steps that are involved in your capsule filling. Moving ahead, let us see the first machine that you are going to see, a small scale machine for capsule filling, that is hand-operated capsule filling machine. Hand-operated capsule filling machine, it consists of two plates. This is one plate and this is the second plate. It consists of two plates having number of holes. So this is one plate over here and this is second plate over here, right? So this is this plate, the second plate is fixed to the machine, whereas the upper plate, so you have an upper plate and lower plate. This upper plate is movable, whereas this lower plate, okay, this is fixed. So this is the lower plate, not this one. Sorry, this may be for alignment, right? So you have an upper plate, okay? You have an upper plate over here and you have a lower plate over here. This lower plate is fixed, whereas the upper plate is movable. In the first step, what you do is, you place this plate, okay, this upper plate on this lower plate. After you place this plate, you place the capsules inside it. The capsules are placed over here inside it. Now there are some other things that are also present. You have a big handle and you have a smaller handle. This smaller handle, with the help of this smaller handle, what you do is, you lock the bodies. The bodies are locked inside this plate, inside this lower plate. So once these bodies are locked, you remove this upper plate. After removing this upper plate, what happens is, the caps are now coming into this upper plate, whereas the body, they remain in the lower plate. Right? Then what you do is, Then you place this powder tray. So this is the powder tray. Okay. This is the powder tray which you have placed over here. Once you place the powder tray onto this, now you are going to put powder inside it. After putting the powder, with the help of the scraper, has the scraper been shown over here? No. Okay, the scraper is not shown. With the help of the scraper, you are going to spread this powder in the capsule body. With the help of gravity, this powder is going to get filled inside the capsule body. Right? After that, what you are going to do is, you are going to lower this pin plate. Okay, this is the pin plate. This pin plate is having number of pins. If you can see over, it is having number of pins. This pin plate presses the powder, okay, that is gone inside the body. So once this is lower, okay, you turn it, whereby these pins go inside, they coincide with the holes that are present over here. So there are number of holes that are present over here. These pins coincide with these holes, and once the body is placed over here and the powder is been placed into it, once you can press these powders with the help of these pin holes. Okay, so the powder is pressed. You take this plate which you have earlier removed, which is with the cap. You place it onto the body, right? You move this handle down. Okay, once you move this handle down, okay, in this way, what is going to happen? The bodies, they are going to go and fit inside the cap. Okay. Now again, you remove the upper plate and you just turn it upside down and you remove your capsules. If you have not understood it, see the video. Okay. You'll understand it in a more better way. Okay. So this is the first step where you have oriented the capsule and the body. Okay. In the second step, what you're doing is, you have joined the body, okay, and you have removed the upper plate. The upper plate is containing the caps, while the lower plate is containing all the bodies. Okay, you press the bodies below, then you are putting the powder, that is the formulation. After putting the formulation, what you are doing is, you are spreading the formulation, whereby the bodies are totally filled now with the material, right? Then what you are doing is, you are again putting this upper plate onto the lower plate, and then you are putting the cap body inside it. Just see this video. These are the pins which I was talking about. This is the lower plate. This is the bigger handle. This will help to push your bodies inside the cap at the end. This is the lower plate, and this over here, if you, this lever is going to lock the bodies inside this lower plate.
This machine is ready for your capsule filling. Now, one loading plate and some capsules.
Now what he is doing is, he is loading the, he is orienting the capsule.
Lower side and tape is upper side. Like this.
This is orientation. Alignment of capsules.
If you fill the full plate, now
he is placing it. Well, once you turn this lever, what is happening is, the bodies are getting locked now.
And this lever is left side. Now opening.
Is raising the upper plate.
You can see here, tape is unloading plate. All bodies in the machine. Release the lever. This is a powder filling plate. This is the
This is the formulation that is pouring inside it. The powder is getting compressed inside the body.
If the powder is remaining some air, you can also try 1 times more. Release the tray. Again, put the
Sanjana, I will answer your question. Now what he has done is he has moved the up handle over this handle, he has pressed. So what happens because of this is the body goes inside the cap. Now the body has locked in, the body is locked inside the cap.
The rate of this machine is 20,000 capsules in a day.
Okay. Okay, understood? Hello, have you understood? Sanjana, to answer your question, but how would you ensure that every capsule has the same amount of filled material inside it? Fantastic question. Okay, I was expecting this question. Okay, now let us move ahead. Okay, and let me tell you how this can be ensured. Okay, I just wanted now what you're doing is, you have a bodies that are there. So bodies are placed over here, right? Now there are how many bodies? Let us imagine there are 100 bodies. Okay, 100 bodies are placed over here. We know the filling capacity. We know the volume that can be filled. As we know, because the size of the capsule is known to us, we have selected the particular size of capsule. What we know is we know the volume. We know the density also. So we know the amount of material that can be filled into it. Let us assume that the amount of material that can be filled into it is 50 milligram. Just for an example. Okay, let us assume that. So what we are now trying to do is, and we have to fill how many capsules? We have to fill 100 capsules. So kitna material humko fill karna hai? So we have to fill 100 into say 50 milligram. Just for an example. So it comes to 5000 milligram. This much amount of drug, this much amount of formulation has to be filled into this 100 capsules. Correct? Are you getting me up till here? So what I am going to do is, I am going to take this 500 milligram of material and I am going to place into this powder tray. And what I am going to do is, I am going to uniformly distribute it. Right? When I am distributing, once this has been filled, okay, supposing this capsule is filled, the next capsule is going to be get filled. Okay. And then the next capsule or all are going to get filled simultaneously. But the amount of material that can be filled in the capsule is only 50 milligram. So 50 milligram se jyada to is capsule mein jane wala nahi hai. 50 milligram se jyada is capsule mein jane wala nahi hai. 50 milligram se jyada is capsule mein jane wala nahi hai. So in all, each and every capsule will be having how much? Only 50 milligram it will be having. It won't be having more. Sanjana, is my do you understand the whatever I told you? So in this way, each and every capsule is going to have only 50 milligram. Okay, once you spread all the powder, okay, and no powder is remaining on this tray, you can very well say that each capsule is now filled with 50 milligrams. Total humne kitna liya? 5000 milligram humne liya. And we have distributed into how many? We have distributed into 100 capsules. It means what? Each capsule is having how much? Each capsule is having only 50 milligram. Is it clear, Sanjana? That is why I have asked you the earlier one. कि कौन सा साइज का कैप्सूल आप ऑर्डर करोगे, उसी साइज का कैप्सूल आप ऑर्डर करोगे एंड दैट यू आर गोइंग टू प्लेस इन द ट्रे. संजना, एम आई क्लियर? बाय द टाइम संजना आंसर्स, लेट अस मूव फर्दर. योर ऑडियो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू?
यस सर, यू आर क्लियर. आई गॉट इट.
यू गॉट इट ना? एवरीबडी एल्स आल्सो गॉट इट? नाउ लेट अस मूव टू द Let us move now to the second machine, that is semi-automatic capsule filling machine. Again, I will explain you the machine first and then you can go to the video. Now, this machine consists of a hopper, right? I'll explain you the parts first. If this machine consists of a hopper, this hopper is used, this hopper contains the formulation. So, the formulation is present inside this hopper. Like your tablet is having a hopper, this is also having a hopper. So this is the hopper. Here the rectification of capsule, this step is known as the rectification step. I'm going to show you the video of it, where the capsule and the body are aligned. The caps are aligned on the top and the bodies are aligned below. This is the capsule holding tray, empty gelatin capsule holding tray. Okay, so this is the empty gelatin capsule holding tray. These are the two plates. You have plate one and plate two. The difference over here, both the plates are movable. In the earlier machine, one of the plate was fixed, whereas the top plate, okay, it was the top plate, it was what? Movable, right? Over here, both the plates are movable. This plate and this plate, upper and the lower plate, both the plates are movable, right? Got it? So what you are going to do is, first you are going to place the upper plate on the lower plate and place these two plates below this rectifier or capsule filling machine. So this capsules, the empty gelatin capsules, are now going to get filled inside this tray. Okay, these both these rings, they are known as rings, right? In these rings, in the upper ring and the lower ring, now the capsules are going to get filled. How they are going to get filled? As I told you earlier, caps are going to be on the top and body below. Then what you are going to do is, you are going to apply vacuum. Here there are some pressure buttons over here. With the help of the button, you are going to apply the vacuum. So once you apply the vacuum, what is going to happen? The lower plate, okay, the capsules are going to go inside the lower plate, okay, whereas the caps are going to remain in the upper plate. Now you are going to separate these two plates. So the body is going to remain separate and the cap is going to become separate. Now after separating it, the body plate, the body ring, you are going to place below this hopper, right? And then you are going to fill the powders that is present over the formulation inside the capsule. Right? Got it? Then again, what you are going to do is, you are going to place this upper plate onto this lower plate. And with the help of the pins that are over here, you are going to fix this body inside the cap. And with the help of the same pins, you are now going to remove the body. How is the process carried out? Let us see in the next video. This is the This is the rectification process only. I have just show you the rectification process. This is rectification station. See, they are filling. The capsule is getting filled. If you see over here, the capsule is getting filled inside this ring. See over here.
Now we have 5
This is a rectification stage. Let us see the whole process now. Now you are able to hear the audio also, na? You are able to hear the audio?
Not clearly, sir.
Okay, it's fine. Matlab, itna jyada bhi. If you want, I can share these videos also. If you want to audio, listen to audio. These are the two plates that he has placed on one another. So now you know the density of the powders. Okay. You know the volume that can be filled in the capsules. So with the help of density of powders, you are going to, and the amount that you have to fill inside the capsules, you are going to select adequate number of capsule, the proper size of capsule, and that size of capsules you are going to fill in this ring. The rings are also going to be different. As the size changes, the ring is also going to change. Here is applying the vacuum. He's checking also and he's applying the vacuum also. So now in the lower plate, the body has been moved. So he's just going to lift the upper plate. So the upper plate and the lower plate, they are now separated. And the body has gone into the lower plate. He's keeping the upper plate over there. And lower plate he's bringing below the hopper. Now he's going to pull the hopper onto the body. See, now the hopper has come onto the body. Here it has come. And it is moving. So once this powder has been totally filled, okay, once these bodies are totally filled, you can say what? That the powder filling has taken place. These are the pins on which he is going to place it. Now he is going to shift the bodies inside the cap. If you see these pins over here, just see the pins over here. Just see the pins, how they are moving. See, they are moved up. Okay. So what has happened is the bodies have gone inside the cap. Now the same pins, okay, are going to push the bodies outside. Understood? Yes or no? Those who have not understood, please tell me.
Sir, actually, the part where the pins were moving, the video just hanged.
One minute, Jivika, you had one thing in chat box. So basically, 50 milligram is the upper limit, right, sir? No, no, beta. I have told you that anything can be filled. As I told you over here, the amount of material in my earlier site, Jivika, this is, she had raised the question. I'm sorry. So Jivika, the amount of material that can be filled can vary from 39 milligram. Over here you can see it ranges from 39 milligram, okay, to it can range from 1330 milligram. In so what size of capsule you are choosing and what is the density depending upon that the amount of material will be there. Please remember this. That's why I have taken this. Are you understanding, Jivika? So anything, any amount of material can be filled. In my example, 50 was the right answer. That 50 could have been filled in my example. But depending upon how much amount of material I want to fill inside it, and what is the, so I know what is the amount of material. So I want to fill 300 milligram of material. So that is the problem that I gave you. So now let us take an example that I have to, sorry. Let us take an example that I have to fill. Okay. Amount of material that I have to fill is 259 milligram. This is the amount of material that I have to fill. And I know that the powder density is 0.7. This is the density of my powder. ये दो तो मुझे पता चल सकता है, ये तो मेरा formulation है, मुझे पता चलेगा. So depending upon that, what I am going to do is, I am going to check this with this, and then I am going to correlate. So what I have to do is, so now I have to fill, I have to select which size tablet, which size capsules I have to order for size 2 capsule. Okay, and I have to select the size 2 ring. Inside that size 2 ring, I have to place the size 2 capsules. Okay. Which is and in the hopper I have to place the powder which is having density 0.7, and then I have to move these bodies below the hopper. So what is going to get filled? 259 milligram of powder is going to get filled, because that is the maximum volume of this size capsule for this density. This capsule for a separate density will be having a separate kind of an volume in milligram, volume, okay, or capacity in milligrams. Am I clear now, Jivika? Jivika, am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, this was about the hand operated. Then we went on to see your semi-automatic. Now, let us see the automatic capsule filling machine, okay? Now, in semi-automatic, you must have seen some of the steps are carried out by the operator himself. He lifts the, rings, he places below the rectifier, then he removes, he separates the caps and bodies, then he places the ring below the hopper, and then the filling takes place, and so on and so forth. So, some of the steps are carried out with the help of the operator. In automatic capsule filling machine, it is a, and that was a batch process. एक रिंग में सपोजिंग देयर आर से 1000 होल्स देन 700 टू 800 होल्स देन इन वन बैच 700 टू 800 कैप्सूल्स इन वन राउंड 700 टू 800 कैप्सूल्स कुड बी फिल्ड इफ यू टेक योर हैंड ऑपरेटेड इन वन बैच नियर अबाउट 100 कुड बी फिल्ड राइट ओवर हियर इट इज अ कंटीन्यूअस प्रोसेस व्हाट डज इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ पाउडर हॉपर द पाउडर हॉपर इज ओवर हियर which can fill the powders or it can fill the liquid. You can have a powder hopper, you can have a liquid hopper over here, you can have a semi-solid hopper over here, which can fill the powder, you can fill the liquid, or you can fill the semi-solids. Liquids and semi-solids can also be filled now in a hard gelatin capsule, the latest trend, the latest trend. Earlier it was only filled in the soft gelatin capsule. Okay. Then you have the dosing plunger. These dosing plunger, what they do is they fill this powders inside this capsules. Okay. Dosing chamber is again the same thing. Then you have a faulty rejection stage, in which if the capsules are not filled, or if there is some chamber which is remained to be filled with the capsule, empty gelatin capsules, okay, or if some cap is not been placed on the capsule, or there is some problem, then the capsules are getting removed from the system, okay. Then you have the capsule hopper. This is the capsule hopper that is placed over here, okay, and from here through these chambers, through these rectification chambers, the capsules are placed inside the magazine. So these are the magazines. If you see over here, these are the magazines, right? These are the magazines. Magazines are nothing but in hand operated you call them as trays, in semi-automatic you call them as rings, whereas over here you call them as magazine. Okay, so these are the magazine. You have the upper magazine and you have the lower magazine. The upper magazine holds the caps, whereas the lower magazine holds the body. Okay, so this capsule hopper, through this rectification rectification chamber, okay, it feeds the magazine with the help of the capsule. in the further stage, okay, if you see over here, in the further stage from here, once it goes over here, what happens is in the next stage, again the capsule, the cap and the body, they are getting separated. Now the bodies, they pass through the hopper, right? The body is getting filled. Further in this stage, what happens is the cap and the body, they get joined to each other. Then in the further stage over here, the capsules are getting removed from the system. Okay, the filled capsules are getting removed and they are ready for packaging. Okay, let us see how the stages takes place. Okay, so once again, this is the rectification stage. The capsules are filled. In the second stage, they are getting separated. Okay, in the next stage, they are getting the powders are getting filled inside it. In the next stage, they are getting joined, and in the final stage, the capsules are getting removed. Okay, so this is the tray from where it is getting removed and it is getting collected. The filled capsules are getting collected. Okay, so this is our steps for the liquid filled hard capsule. This I have taken from this reference. Okay, the author is Milind Biyani. Okay, he has given the steps that are incorporated into the liquid filled hard capsules. So same are the stage, ज़्यादा कुछ फर्क नहीं है इसमें. Okay, and let us see now the machine. Now this is the rectification stage. I hope you are able to hear me because I have not put the this. This is the rectification stage. So this rectification is going on. Now, if you see over here, just see over here. The you further when you go, you will see that the capsule, the upper magazine is getting separated from the lower magazine. This is filling of the material. Now the lower plate has gone inside it. Okay, वो यहाँ गया है and it has gone below it. Whereas the upper plate is remaining over here only. See, this is अगर आपने थोड़ी देर पहले देखा होगा तो कुछ कुछ कैप्सूल यहां से निकल रहे हैं. Over here you must have seen. That was the rejected capsules. These are the final capsules. These are the two magazines over here. They are again joining now. So this process continuously goes on. From here, the capsules are transferred. The empty gelatin capsules are transferred into the capsule holding hopper. So this is the hopper which is holding capsule. This is the hopper which is holding the material. These are the dosing units. So here, the right amount out of material is going inside the capsule. Okay. How this happen, how the dosing takes place, okay, that I'll be explaining in my next lecture. That will be after your sessional examinations. From here, the rejected capsules are getting removed. If you see some capsules going inside over here, so those are the reject. See, now this is a rejected capsule. See, this is how the magazines have got separated. Can you see over here? And it went inside, this magazine went inside the dosing chamber. Clear? You must have understood it. So the times are up. Time is up. These are the steps that are involved in the automatic capsule filling.